This is Mrs. Appiah with lesson 20. Every line is a graph of a linear equation. Pause the video and copy the essential question. How do you write the equation that represents a line on a graph? We're going to skip the opening exercise. We are also going to skip this page. Starting with example 1. Given a line, we want to be able to write the equation that represents it. Which form of a linear equation do you think will be most valuable for this task? The standard form, ax plus by equals c, or slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. Actually, y equals mx plus b will be the most efficient. The reason is that you can see the slope in the equation and you can see the y-intercept. Also, in the graph, you can see the slope by calculating the distance between PR and PQ, and also you can see the y-intercept. So the form that will make it easiest to write the equation will be the slope-intercept form. That's what we'll be using. So what we want to do is we want to label P, Q, and R so that we can find the slope. Locate on your graph integers that can be used for P, Q, and R. So I'm going to label over here, this is point P, and this is point R, and this is point Q. And remember when you're finding the slope that it is a ratio that compares the distance between QR to the distance between PQ. The distance of QR, recall that is called the rise. And the distance between PQ, that is called the run. And this makes up our slope. So our rise is actually falling down 2. So that's going to be a negative 2. And the run is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. So that is going to be our slope, M. Next, we want to locate or find the y-intercept. So we want to see where this line crosses the y-axis, which is right here. This is B, called the y-intercept. So our y-intercept is a positive 4. Next, write your equation. Y equals mx plus b. This is the slope-intercept form of the equation. Then we'll replace m with the slope, which is negative 2/5. And we'll replace b, the y-intercept, with 4. So our equation of the line is y equals negative 2/5 x plus 4. This is the equation of the line. Example 2. What is the y-intercept of the line? So we'll see where the line crosses the y-axis is right here at negative 2. This is called the y-intercept. Remember that represents the variable b in the slope-intercept form. Next, what is the slope of the line? So we are going to label P, R, and Q. I'll call this point P. Remember that you want to locate an integer for that ordered pair. That's point R, and then this would be point Q, where they intersect at a right angle. When we're finding our slope, recall that the slope is the ratio between the distance between QR and the distance from PQ. The distance of QR is called the rise, and the distance of PQ is called the run. So our rise is 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is a negative. Oh, wait, it is not negative, it is positive, because we have a positive and a positive. So that is a positive. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's 4. And then the run is a positive 1. So our slope is 4. And remember, that is represented by the variable m. Next, the slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. We're going to take the m out and put the slope in. So we've got y equals 4x, and we're going to take the b out and put in the y-intercept, which is negative 2. And then we'll rewrite this equation, and instead of writing adding a negative, we'll change that to simple subtraction. So the equation of the line is y equals 4x minus 2. This is the slope-intercept form for the equation. Example 3. What is the y-intercept of the line? Our y-intercept is located right here. Notice on this graph that the units of the coordinate plane have changed, and they are going by tens. So our y-intercept is 10, 20, 30, 40. Our y-intercept is negative 40. And remember, in our equation, the y-intercept represents the variable b. Next, the slope of the line. To find the slope of the line, remember to label P, Q, and R. I'll use this for point P, and then I need to locate point R at an integer. That'd be right over here on the x-axis. Label it R. Now see where they intersect at a right angle, and label that point Q. Recall that your slope is the rise over the run. The rise is the distance between QR, and the run is the distance from P to Q. One, two, three, four, five. So our run is 5. Our rise, 1, 2, 3, 4, is 4. So we have a slope of 4 over 5. We've got our y-intercept, and we've got our slope. So now we're ready to write our equation. The graph of the line, that'll be up here. Our equation is y equals mx plus b. That is the slope-intercept form. Now we'll replace the variables m and b with their values. Y equals, for m, we have 4/5. Bring down the variable x. And then plus b. Notice that b is negative. So you can write plus negative 40 and then change it to negative 40. Or just minus 40, or you can just write minus 40. If you are more comfortable doing this in two steps, then by all means, do it in two steps. All right, so this is our slope-intercept form of the line. Next, would you add these directions to the bottom of your page? Now, write the equation in standard form. Ax plus by equals c, where a, b, and c are integers, and a is not negative. Pause the video and copy down those directions. All right, so we'll get started. I'm just going to rewrite the equation. Y equals 4/5 x minus 40. So we have a couple of things that we need to do. We will need to move 4/5 x to the left side of the equation. Also, a, b, and c need to be integers. And right now, if we think of it in terms of ax plus by equals c, we'll notice that the coefficient of x is not an integer, it is a fraction. So we will need to change that to an integer. And then the last thing is we need to make sure that a is not negative in our answer. The first thing we want to do is make sure that a, b, and c are integers. To do that, we will multiply our entire equation. What would you need to multiply 4/5 by in order to get it to be an integer? You would need to multiply it by the denominator, 5. So that would be 5 over 1. That would give you 20 over 5, which is 4. So you will be multiplying by the denominator. And notice that that leaves you just with your numerator as a whole number. So here we're going to multiply by the denominator of 5. You need to multiply the entire equation by 5. So let's go ahead and do that. We have 5 times y. That's 5y. 5 times 4/5 x is 4x. Bring down your minus sign, and 5 times 40 is 200. So now we have a, b, and c all integers. Next, we need to move 4x to the left side of the equation so that it's in standard form. To do that, I will need to subtract 4x from both sides of the equation. And I'll simplify that, keeping it in standard form order. So I have negative 4x plus 5y equals negative 200. So I've got them in the correct order now, but notice that a is negative, and it needs to be not negative. In order for it to be not negative, I will need to multiply the entire equation by what? By negative 1. So first I'm going to multiply negative 4x by 1, and that's going to give me a positive 4x. I'm going to multiply 5y by negative 1, and that's going to give me a negative 5y. Remember to write that as just minus 5y. And I'm going to multiply negative 200 by negative 1, and that's going to give me a positive 200. So now, my equation is in the form of ax plus by equals c. Here's the ax, here's the by, and here's the c. And a, b, and c are all integers, no fractions, no decimals. And a is not negative. So I have completed the process. The steps that we did here, we multiplied by the denominator. Then we subtracted 4x from both sides of the equation. Then we multiplied by negative 1. You won't always need to multiply by negative 1, but if a, the coefficient of x, is negative, when it's in standard form, then you will need to multiply it by negative 1. All right, let's continue with exercise 1. Write the equation that represents the line shown. Then we'll use the properties of equality to change the equation from slope-intercept form to standard form. All right, the first thing that we want to do, we want to label P, Q, and R. The reason that we're doing that is so that we can find the slope. So you want to locate an integer. Here's a spot right here. And then I see there's another one right up here. So I'm going to label that P and R. Then I'm going to draw the right angle and label it Q. Recall that our slope is the rise over the run, where the rise is the distance from Q to R here. And then the run is the distance from P to Q, which is the horizontal distance. So my run, P to Q, is 2. And then my rise, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, is 6. And I can simplify that to 3. And that is, do you remember, is it M or B? It is M. The slope is the variable M. All right, so remember you've got your equation y equals mx plus b. And we found m, and now we want to find b. And that was called the what? The y-intercept. So next, we are going to locate the y-intercept. That is where the line crosses the y-axis. So that is at positive 2. Now we're ready to write our equation. Y equals mx plus b. This is the slope-intercept form. Now we'll replace the variable m with our value of 3. So we have 3x. Then I'll replace the y-intercept with 2. And this is the slope-intercept form of this line. Next, we're going to use the properties of equality to change the equation from slope-intercept form to standard form. Ax plus by equals c. A, b, and c are going to be integers, and a is not negative. The first thing that we want to do is make sure that a, b, and c are integers. And they already are integers. For example, this is a 1, this is a 3, and this is a 2. So they are already integers, so we will not have to multiply by the denominator. Next, we want to get them in the right order by moving the x term to the left side of the equation. So I have y equals 3x plus 2. I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides of the equation and then simplify. Here, I have negative 3x plus y equals 2. Now, it is in the right order, but a is negative. In order to make a positive, I'm going to need to multiply the entire equation by what number? By negative 1. So first, I'm going to multiply negative 3x times negative 1, and that's going to give me a positive 3x. I'm going to multiply y by negative 1, and that's going to give me a negative y. And remember to just write that as minus y. Then I'm going to multiply 2 times negative 1, which is negative 2. This is my equation in standard form. A, b, and c are integers, and a is not negative. So we are done with exercise 1. Exercise 2. Write the equation that represents the line shown. first. Label, P, R, and Q. So locate three spots on your graph. Here we go. This will be P, this will be R, and then the right angle will give you Q. Now notice that this is a negative slope. So we've got it labeled. Remember, we do this so that we can find our slope. Our slope is the rise over the run, where the rise is the distance between QR, and the run is the distance between PQ. So our run is 1, 2, 3. And our rise is actually a fall, and it goes down 2, so that's a negative. So in this case, we have a negative slope. Next, you need to locate the y-intercept. So find where the line crosses the y-axis. It crosses the y-axis at negative 1. This will be our variable b in the equation. So we've got our slope-intercept form of y equals mx plus b. We'll replace m with negative 2/3. Replace b with negative 1. Now I'm going to rewrite this. Instead of adding a negative, I write that as simple subtraction. So the equation is y equals negative 2/3 x minus 1. This is the equation of our line. Next, we'll write it in standard form. And we want a, b, and c to be integers. Notice that at this time, a is a fraction. So this is where we will have to multiply by the denominator. And the reason we do this is so that a, b, and c will be integers. So the denominator is what number? 3. So I'm going to multiply the entire equation by 3. So I have 3 times y gives me 3y. 3 times negative 2/3. If you're not sure what that is, go over to the side. Negative 2/3 times 3 is negative 2. So we have negative 2x. And then 3 times minus 1 is minus 3. All right, so we've got our integers. Next, we need to put it in the right form, ax plus by. In order to do that, we need to take care of the negative 2x. In order to move it to the other side, I'm going to add 2x to both sides of the equation. Now I have 2x plus 3y equals negative 3. It is in the right order, and a is not negative. So I have completed the problem. This is standard form of the line. Number 3. Write the equation that represents the line shown. So I'd like you to try this problem on your own. So you're going to find the slope, find the y-intercept, and write the equation. Then use the properties of equality to change the equation from slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b, rather y equals mx plus b, to standard form, ax plus by equals c, so that a, b, and c are integers and a is not negative. Pause the video and complete problem 3, and then resume the video when you're ready to check your work. Pause the video to check your work and make any corrections. Question 4. I'd like you to pause the video and complete question 4 on your own. Then resume the video to correct your work. Pause the video when you correct your work if you need to make any corrections, and bring your questions to class. Number 5, we'll do that in class. Number 6, we will do that in class as well. Please turn to the summary page. Every line is a graph of a linear equation. To write the equation of a line from a graph, you will determine the slope, then find the y-intercept. Write the equation in slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b, and then replace m and b with their values. Let's do one more example. Make sure that you pause the video and copy that into your notes, please. And thank you. All right, so let's take a look at a problem. Would you put a point at y equals negative 2? And put another point at 1, 2. Now, draw a line through those two points. So we're going to write the equation for this line. If you're confident in doing it on your own, go ahead and pause the video while I do it, and then check your work. I am going to find the slope. My slope is equal to 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. My slope is equal to 4 over 1, which is equal to 4, which is the variable m. Then I need to locate my y-intercept. My y-intercept is where the line crosses the y-axis, and that is right here at negative 2. And that is the variable b. Next, I write my equation, y equals mx plus b. And I'm going to replace m and b. So this gives me y equals 4x plus negative 2. If you're comfortable doing this in one step, you could just write y equals 4x minus 2. You'll get used to doing it as you do it more times. Many people skip this step of adding a negative and just simply write minus 2. And that concludes lesson 21. Rather, lesson 20.